Hi, welcome to the WTAMU Virtual Math Lab. This video will step you through College Algebra Tutorial 14, Example 7. In this example, we want to solve the equation 2 times the quantity x minus 1 plus x equals 5 times the quantity 2x plus 3 minus 2 times the quantity x plus 3 for x. The goal here is to get x by itself on one side and everything else on the other side using inverse operations. When we do the inverse operations, we want to make sure that we do the same thing to both sides in order to keep the two sides of the equation equal to each other. It looks like x is on both sides of this equation and it is not by itself. In step 1, we want to simplify each side if needed. It looks like we have some parentheses that can clear out, so it'll make our problem a little nicer to work with. We can do this by applying the distributive property. On the left side, we can distribute the 2 times the x minus 1 and get 2x minus 2 plus x equals, on the right side, 5 times 2x plus 3 is 10x plus 15, and negative 2 times x plus 3 gives us a negative 2x minus 6. We can combine some like terms here to simplify it even further. On the left side, after combining the 2x and the x, we get 3x minus 2. After combining the 10x minus 2x, we get 8x, and 15 minus 6 gives us plus 9 on the right side. In step 2, we want to use the addition and subtraction properties of equality to move the variable term on one side and all other terms to the other side. Let's go ahead and move the 8x that is on the right side over so that we have our x term on the left side. What is the inverse of add? Subtract. So we need to subtract 8x from both sides. On the left side, we'll end up with 3x minus 2 minus 8x equals, and on the right side, we get 8x plus 9 minus 8x. On the left side, when we combine the 3x minus 8x, we get a negative 5x minus 2 equals, on the right side, the 8x's cancel, and we have plus 9. Let's move that constant term of negative 2 to the other side. What is the inverse of subtract? Add. So we need to add 2 to both sides. So we end up with negative 5x minus 2 plus 2 on the left side equals 9 plus 2 on the right side. So we end up with negative 5x equals 11. We are not done because x is not by itself. In step 3, we want to use the multiplication or division property of equality to remove any values that are in front of the variable. We need to move that negative 5 that is being multiplied times the x. What is the inverse of multiply? Divide. So we need to divide both sides by negative 5. When we divide the left side by negative 5, we get negative 5x over negative 5 equals, and the right side is 11 over negative 5. This gives us our final answer of x equals a negative 11 over 5. In step 4, we want to check our answer. Note that if you put a negative 11 over 5 back in for x in the original problem, the two sides will be equal, which shows that the negative 11 over 5 is a solution to our problem.